Yamaji. Mutant. Inventor. Scientist. For you to understand. I need to start at the beginning. In the 21st century, the Glukesberg Corporation rose to a position of world dominance. By 2035, their LifeNet total existence network had linked billions of people across the globe, encompassing social, economic, government, private and public services within one monstrous, ever-evolving system. With LifeNet and the corporation's vast financial resources, Glukesberg accomplished what governments could only hope for. A worldwide populace that wanted to conform, and that was willing to sacrifice privacy for security, safety, and interaction. The CEO, Kram Glukesberg, pooled tens of thousands of scientists together to find a new source of free energy to be used for space exploration. The result was magnetic technology. Glukesberg's space program would be a three-month test of not only magtech, but also citizen explorers, astronauts chosen from the populace. After worldwide selection trials that tested the applicants' athletic capabilities and knowledge of mathematics, physics, and psychology, seven candidates were chosen to enter Glukesberg's training facility. These seven, selected from scientists, athletes, and civilians, would take Glukesberg's technology to the stars. Glukesberg called them his Magrunners. A 500,000 square foot training facility filled with puzzles and physical obstacles was built over the San Andreas Rift. The world watched and waited. This young man is Dax C. Ward. Dax's father, like me, was an expert in genetics and cybernetics. One of the few who had no compunctions about working with a mutant. James and his wife Lavinia became my closest friends. When the accident happened, Dax was left in my care. I raised the boy the best I could, and he soon began to show signs of his father's brilliance. Dax had an aptitude for robotics, genetics, engineering. He read everything he could about Glukesberg's magtech and began to apply the same principles to creating his own technology. By the time he was 11, he had started his own business, repairing and creating new devices. By the time he was 15, he had built and programmed the Newton prototype, a one-of-a-kind electromorph robot. So I suppose that I shouldn't have been surprised when he told me on his 23rd birthday that he wanted to apply for the Glukesberg MagTech program. He had the skills, and he had the brain for it. As we completed work on his custom maglove, I knew he was ready.
My friends, thank you for joining us today. Today, Glukesberg MagTech is proud to unveil our Space Exploration Training Facility. Today is the first day of a three-month training program that'll prepare our Magrunners for space exploration. At our facility, they will not only experiment with MagTech, but also learn to work and live together as they forge our future. Now, let's hear a few words from Xander Deverin, the creator of the facility and genius MagTech engineer.
I've spent considerable time and energy designing the testing facility with functional examples of our new technology. During training periods, contestants will find their bodies and minds pushed to the limits. We will see what they can accomplish individually and later what they are capable of as a group.
Be sure to stay online to see History in the Making, brought to you by the same minds responsible for the LifeNet. After a quick briefing, our seven Magrunners are preparing to enter the facility for the first time.
It's almost showtime, Dax. You ready for this?
I'm nervous, Kamachi. I made it here. Now the real training starts.
The Magrunners' training will be the most important 3 months of their lives. They will pit their skills and wits against the brilliant MagTech engineer, Xander Deveron, who will evaluate their progress. We've been allowed into the facility for the first 24 hours, and we're bringing it to you live via LifeNet.
Don't be nervous, Dax. Stay focused. And remember why you're here. Newton and I will be following on the LifeNet. He says good luck.
No, Gamaji. We're talking about going into space if I pass the training. It's hard to believe.
If your parents were here, I know they'd be very proud of you, as I am. Be sure to test out the new maglev before you start.
Ready, Xander?
Ready.
Let's begin.
Good luck, Dax.
Right. Stay focused.
Welcome to the state-of-the-art, Magrunners! Xander's really outdone himself with this facility. We hope you enjoy this miracle of MagTech modularity.
Thank you.
the Grookersburg MagTech Experience. Brought to you live by LifeNet.
That wasn't so bad, Gamachi. How are the other Magrunners doing?
Don't get too confident. That's just the beginning. 3 months is a long time.
Look at this tech. How did Xander develop this stuff?
Just focus on your training. I'm going to limit our transmissions to the elevators between levels. There's less interference.
Cassandra Shin from LifeNet Media, can you give us a few thoughts about today? How do you feel about being the only Magrunner without outside corporate funding or professional training? Do you think you're at a disadvantage?
What? I have a trainer.
That would be the mutant we've heard about, Gamachi.
Yeah, sorry Ms. Shin, I have to go.
Thank you.